this video, I've trained 1,000 AI knights fight different types of soldiers. They learned how to dominate their opponent, as well as how to be humble, or how I like to call it, how to be a coward. These pendejos even managed to come up with a seemingly dumb strategy that proved to be one of the most creative in the series so far. So make sure to watch till the end this 8th episode of Epic AI Wars. I know you've been waiting for this episode for quite some time now, and Cavalry Unit was one of the most requested soldier types in the entire series. And now it's finally here. Meet the Knight. Compared to regular units such as Warriors or Musketeers that are free to move in any direction and can roam the world freely, well, almost. Knights can only charge forward, as well as rotate left or right, which allows them to change direction. Since everything in my simulation is perfectly balanced without a single OP element, the knights have a very specific and fully arbitrary move speed value of 8, which makes it twice as fast as previous fastest moving unit, the warrior, which while sprinting had a move speed of 4. But that's not it. The longer a knight charges without stopping, faster his move speed becomes. Once our cavalry unit reaches a fast enough speed to deal damage, a force field will appear in front which will damage any enemy in its range. The speed, however, will keep increasing as long as the charge is not interrupted. Similar to warriors, knights are able to deal a ton of damage. Well, if a ton was 100 kilograms instead of 1,000, because he deals 100 damage. This basically means that anyone standing in front of a charging knight will get one-shotted, no matter the soldier type. That being said, knights will only have 50 health points, meaning they also will be one-shotted by any soldier that hits them, making knights a very fast glass cannon. Initially, knights had 100 HP, but despite that, musketeers scared them badly during trainings. Lastly, I made it so warriors can block the charge damage with their shields, but only from enemies in front of them. Doesn't make too much sense, since breaching defenses kinda is the main point of cavalry, I think, but that did result in quite some interesting strategies from the knights, so I will let it pass for now. Let me know in the comments whether I should remove it or keep it. The first training was with 50 knights in team blue and 50 warriors in team red. I did not expect warriors to put too much of a fight, but it would be a good first benchmark to see whether I designed the knights correctly and whether they are training at all. As you can see, at the beginning both soldier types are just as confused, running chaotically in every direction. That being said, it seems warriors are a little more motivated to commit Sudoku by slamming themselves into the wall. Despite that, judging by the bodies of knights in the middle, I can safely assume some warriors managed to land a hit on some of their adversaries. Getting a taste of blood will prove very beneficial for their training, since now they will know that this results in a sweet, sweet reward and will crave for more and more, just like the junkie that he is. After a little bit of mosh pit partying, on round 5, the first knight was able to charge for long enough such that the aura effect appeared, even though for quite a short time frame. But that was enough to unalive one warrior. In just 3 rounds, charging became mainstream and turned from a single knight doing it to the entire cavalry practicing it. That one knight was a trendsetter. Mowing through their enemies, just 1 round later, knights managed to secure their first victory, and from this point, it just went downhill for the warriors. There was no real challenge for the cavalry anymore, so I decided to split the teams apart, having the knights spawn on the left, while warriors spawn on the right. Needless to say, it did not help warriors a single bit, and just gave them a little more time to consider their life choices before getting stomped by thousands of virtual hooves. With this, I went to bed, however, results in the morning were not any different, with warriors being dominated by the knights. But that is to be expected, right? Now, let's test the knights against their arch nemesis, the musketeer. Same idea, but instead of 50 warriors, we have 50 musketeers, and let me tell you, it was brutal. It started more or less neutral, with both sides having almost identical numbers of casualties, however I'm pretty sure most of musketeers' casualties are caused by friendly fire from other musketeers, but that sounds like their problem, not mine. Please just ignore the fact that the red team's name is Warriors, I forgot to change it. On round 27, Musketeers finally managed to hunt down all of the knights, securing their first victory, and with that I went to bed, but oh boy, I did not expect to see what I saw in the morning. Knights being forever scarred and traumatized by the endless bullying from Musketeers were not able to secure a single win, resulting in this weird strategy where all of them are cowardly trying to keep distance both from their oppressors and the walls. I don't think I have ever seen this kind of behavior, definitely not in the AI Wars series. Luckily, it's just a game and we don't have to feel bad for them. Yay! Wow! Okay, so knights are dominating warriors and get dominated by Musketeers. Basically what I intended to achieve, so far so good. Now it's finally time for a fair fight. Team Red will now consist of 50% warriors and 50% Musketeers, while Team Blue will once again be knights only. Also, this time knights will only have 50 health points, making them an easier target for Musketeers. I'll not bore you with the training process, but after more than 10 hours of training, here is the final result. We will have 500 AI Knights in Team Blue fight against 500 Musketeers and Warriors from Team Red. Pause this video right now and let me know in the comments, who do you think is gonna win, Team Blue or Team Red? By the way, thanks to Alric Wang for pointing out that MVP actually stands for Most Valuable Pogo. However, I once again forgot to change that in the simulation. Yeah, we'll hope the third time is the charm and I won't forget it in the next video. The chaos ensued from the get-go, with Musketeers indiscriminately blasting in all directions, and despite around 30 eliminated knights, about 100 soldiers were unalived by friendly fire in Team Red, but that was just the beginning. Two huge waves of knights are charging right now towards the Team Red. First and main wave is pushing the center in what I guess is an attempt to wreak havoc in enemy team and distract their attention, while the second wave is flanking on the southern side of the battlefield. I'll be honest with you, initially I thought I messed up the training, because I could not find an explanation to why the entire cavalry won't just rush forward stomping everyone ahead, since that would be much easier than all this flanking. But then I got it, and the answer is actually quite obvious in the hindsight. Remember in the beginning I mentioned that warriors are able to block the damage from charging knights? Well, that is the reason. When charging forward, knights realize they unalive much less soldiers compared to when approaching from a side, since warriors can only block damage in front of their shields. So they ended up with the strategy we see now. I very much love machine learning. The stampede has started with knights penetrating enemy defense lines and cleaning up territory, allowing the other knights to safely join the fight. Team Red attempted to hold them off, but now they are getting overwhelmed from two sides simultaneously. Well, actually three sides. Not only they are pushed by the cavalry, but they are also constantly shot in the back by their brothers in arms. Team Red is suffering tremendous losses while slowly being encircled by the cavalry. At this point, the outcome of the fight is already quite clear, and the cavalry is getting rid of the remaining opponents, as well as chasing down the survivors who somehow managed to escape the stampede and are now scattered along the battlefield. You would think it should be easy sail for the knights from now on, however in attempts of chasing down the remaining soldiers, it seems some of them were not able to handle the horse controls and slammed into the walls, resulting in several more dozen knights sudokuing themselves or being shot down by the survivors. Alright, that's cool and all, but the fun just begins. What would happen if we had 500 knights, brave ones, not the ones we saw during the training against Musketeers, and make them fight against 500 of those Musketeers, but with friendly fire turned off? This time I removed the warriors and the friendly fire, so let the meat grinder begin. The waves of bullets went off immediately, wiping down tens of knights at a time, all the Musketeers being able to participate in the defense of the front lines now. The knights are doing their best to get closer, but it's like they hit an invisible wall. Invisible yet very painful. All of these animations and particles, damn that's satisfying. Let me know if you would like me to try the same thing, but with 5000 knights instead of 500. Looks like some knights were able to get really close to the Musketeers, but got spanked before they managed to deal any damage. The cavalry is down to only 7 soldiers, and those are the ones who remembered the strategies of their ancestors and ran for their lives as far from the Musketeers as possible. Soon after, they did come back and met their fate. Alright, but what if we take 500 knights and make them fight another 500 knights? Honestly, the results looked so pretty, so instead of me giving my dumb commentary and ruining it, I will let you enjoy a beautiful time lapse. Now that was dope. Huge thanks to my Patreon subscribers Spartan King, Cabernet and Red Nugget. Each one of you brings my dream of becoming a full-time YouTuber one step closer. If you'd like to be part of my future projects, support me and my content, or just want a shout out at the end of each video, consider subscribing to my Patreon page. Link in the description. Meanwhile, check out this video where I trained 300 AI Spartans to withstand against 10,000 Persian warriors. I even added a Spartan kick. Bye.